24 hours after, obviously, the win against India. What are your thoughts on the win?
I thought it was probably one of the best wins we've ever had against India. It was quite convincing. It was the first time since we've got on tour to this 2020 World Cup that we've felt like we've gelled a lot and we're getting on again. We've got the buzz back. We're talking a lot more to each other, spending more time together. It's because it's quite a hard environment at the minute. We've got about four or five teams in the same hotel and in the same communal area. It's quite hard, to get on with your teammates. But we've got the buzz back now, and the win yesterday just proved that.
So it was pretty one-sided, wasn't it, against a side who people thought would be your main rivals for the group?
Yeah, it definitely was one-sided, I think. We got them 9 down, could have had them all out for 112. But we finished it off without losing a wicket. And I know a few people have said that, if you get one or two wickets against us, you've got us, but not necessarily at all. We bat all the way down to 11, and we've proved that in lots of games against the boys during this cricket season already. So we're very confident with our top order anyway, but even if we lose there, we're still very confident to finish the game off anyway.
What do you think about your performance yesterday? It seemed like you were quite annoyed when you came off the field.
I'm very pleased with my figures, to be honest. I only went for 14 of 4, which, if you go for 24, 26, you should still be happy. 14 looks pretty good against that. I was disappointed I didn't pick up a few wickets. I had a few good shouts, and I could have made a run out. I'm quite hard on myself. I like to keep a high standard, so I'll probably never be happy. Probably the only time I've been really pleased is when we won the World Cup. And, it's just, when the team's working well, it doesn't really matter what you do yourself. But, you come here to play your best game, and when you don't, sometimes you've got to be selfish and get either a good innings like Tails when she gets 100, or when Lottie when she gets 79 or something like that. If you don't bring things like that to the game, you sort of feel like, you're not needed as much. But
in a way, going for so few runs actually set the innings up, didn't it?
If I'm being tight at my end, if I can bowl a maiden in 2020 cricket, that's ridiculous. So at the other end, you expect a wicket to happen, wouldn't you? So it swings and roundabouts, and I just hope that I'm going to take a few wickets the next game.
I guess confidence must be quite high.
They're dark horses to win, Sri Lanka and Pakistan. They've got a lot of enthusiasm, and they're very determined teams to play against. When they come out swinging, they can get a few cheeky fours here and there. So we've still got to bring our best game, and we want to improve every game. So you never know.
Sort of World Cup mentality there, do you think?
Definitely. We try to stay together as a team as much as we can, keep the buzz going, keep the training sessions short and sharp, and keep your focus on what your role is, and also a role as a team. So it's definitely carry on from the World Cup. We're just picking it up at another stage, because we want to improve every time. And obviously, it's a different format of the game. It's more like a lottery, so we want to make it more, not so much a lottery, so much that we know what we're doing, what our roles are, and if we do it, we'll win. So we're definitely carrying on.
What would it sort of mean to you? I know you won't want to look too far ahead, but what would it mean to you to play in front of a full house at the Oval or Trent Bridge in the semi-final?
We don't ever get to play against 20,000 people, so that in itself is a big achievement. To win 2 World Cups in a row would be absolutely amazing. To win it in England would be even better. Even when the men can't do so well, we hope to bring it back and just bring that bit of spark back into England and to the support network and things like that. So it all means a lot to us.